Hi, today I'm going to check out a 1981 Peavey Solo Series Bandit. Now if you check out Wikipedia, this one is listed actually as the second version. The first one being an amp from 1980 that's just called Peavey Bandit. That one is on the internet often referred to as the Gunsmoke Bandit. But I have never been able to find one of these. It's only referred to with a kind of a grainy photocopy of a picture. So if any one of you have some pictures of that amp, I'm really curious about that. I'll discuss more about the Gunsmoke Bandit at the end as well. And I'm also going to discuss the sound of this Solo Series Bandit at the end of the clip. So stick around for that also. Cheers. As you could hear, the Peavey combo speaker here, the Scorpion, is quite a dark speaker. If you compare to the Greenbacks in the Marshall cab I used here, but I think the dark character is quite useful It probably won't cut through in any dense mix, but it's. I think it's a really organic mid. It doesn't sound like it's lacking something. It sounds like an entity that could sound like that. Not that something is muffled, at least to me. And also mentioned the Peavey Bandit version that's listed as the first one in Wikipedia, released in 1980. I found two different versions of that one too. So the Solo Series Bandit would be the third version then. You know, there is a survey online about PVMs called Timeline or something like that. You can see a link to it in the video description. And there you have a photocopy of a grainy photocopy of the PV Bandit with the Bandit written in the Gunsmoke font. But also on the PV website, you have a section called Timeline, and there you have a picture of a 1980 PV Bandit as well. But there you have another logo. It's a cowboy hat and a scarf, and it says Bandit. At least I think so. And the interesting thing, if you compare that one to the one with the Gunsmoke font, this one has a different EQ. I think it has a parametric mid or something like that. So, then there are two versions before the first Solo Series. But I haven't been able to find either of these amps apart from these blurry photocopies. So if any one of you have any pictures or information of these amps, I'd love to hear or see about that. All right, this was even nerdier than usual. Cheers.